You can create and format a doc right from inside Gemini now. Yeah, really. Plus, you can iterate on code and transform your ideas into working prototypes. I know. Oh, and did I mention you can create podcasts right from Gemini now too? We've got a lot to discuss. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode, and on this YouTube channel, I share a ton of tech content like this and Google tips and tactics just like this. And we have a huge Gemini update to discuss. It's time to meet Gemini Canvas. This may just revolutionize the way you use Gemini as you know it. So you might be thinking, what is Gemini Canvas and what the heck is she talking about? Canvas is an interactive space within Gemini where you can write and work on documents and code, and you can see your edits and Gemini suggestions in real time. Hello, efficiency. Scrolling through this information here, you can use Gemini Canvas to refine drafts, whether that's a presentation, speeches, or documents. You can use it to create study games and quizzes. You can even share those with your friends and family. You can get help with coding and visualize how algorithms work. You can even experiment with gravity using a physics particle simulator. And by the way, you can click on any of these to play with an example. So you can get an idea here of what things will look like and how it works. It's actually pretty neat. And by the way, there are other examples of use cases as well on this page, like system prototype management, creating an interactive price slider, there's a 3D planet generator, there's a ton of other cool use cases. I have linked to this Google Canvas overview page for you in the description below so you can play around with all of these as well. So now that you know what Canvas is, here's how to use Gemini Canvas. And we'll cover creating and formatting a doc and iterating on code, but just keep in mind all those other things you can do with Canvas. You're gonna head to gemini.google.com as you normally would. And instead of typing in a prompt right away, click on Canvas in the prompt box. And you might get some handy examples here from Gemini on other things Canvas can help you with. But for this, let's say we simply want to write a 3-page essay on why the Montreal Canadiens are the greatest hockey team to ever exist. Include history and up-to-date stats. I'm gonna hit enter, and in a matter of seconds, we've got our canvas generated to the right of our prompt window. And holy moly, how much does this look like we're used to in Google Docs? Can you believe this? You can completely edit this right in here now. You can take out something you don't like, and maybe we'll add in something we want to say instead. You can highlight some text to ask Gemini right from this canvas. You can use these options here to change the length, change the tone, or suggest edits. Plus, we have some formatting options at the top, just like we're used to in Google Docs. And you could simply copy this out using the copy button near the top right, or you can share it out via a link so others can view this canvas directly via the link. Or my favorite is to export to Docs right from Gemini. This will export it right to a standalone Google Doc for you. So with one prompt, we have created and formatted an entire doc. Love. And let's head back into Gemini. And you can close out of this canvas view at any time and simply reopen it from your chat window. So now let's learn how to generate, iterate, and preview code using Canvas. This is so cool. We're gonna start with the same steps here by clicking on Canvas in our prompt bar and create a simple landing page for my robotics project. We are building small learning robots. I'm going to hit enter, and now our canvas has popped out here and it is writing code for us. And okay, you might be like, cool, like couldn't we have kind of done this before? Just hang on a second. Give it a few seconds and you're going to see that it is going to use this code to build an actual preview for us of this robotics project landing page. And then right from here, we can copy this link where you could share it with anyone to preview it in full screen. How cool is this? But you can preview this right in Gemini, of course. You don't have to leave. And you can click back to code here to revise any lines of code that may not look right. But all of this from a simple prompt. Wowza. But that's not all you can do, because there's yet another Google Gemini update that's gonna look and sound a whole lot like NotebookLM. Which, by the way, you can watch my other Gemini and NotebookLM videos by clicking up here or via the link in the description below. But audio overviews, aka AI-generated podcasts, have come to Gemini. So here's how audio overview works in Gemini. We're once again in a new chat, and this time let's use the plus symbol to upload a file to this chat. Now, if you are familiar with NotebookLM, this is gonna feel a lot like adding a source. I'm gonna simply add this essay on the Montreal Canadiens that we just created and made a doc out of. And you will notice, I don't even have to prompt anything right now. All I've done is add that file, and suddenly I've got this suggestion chip above the prompt bar to generate audio overview. Let's click on generate audio overview chip. And this can take a few minutes, and you do not have to wait around for this, by the way, it'll work in the background. But through the magic of video editing to save us time, we've now got our audio overview generated for us. Now this one happens to be just over 5 minutes long, and let's play a little bit of it to hear what we've got going on.
All right, so we're diving deep today into the Montreal Canadiens.
Yeah.
You know, you sent over a ton of great material about the Habs, their history, how much they've won, and like their place in the culture.
Mm-hmm.
And I think our goal here is to figure out, like, why are the Canadiens such a monumental franchise in hockey?
You know, it really is fascinating when you look at, well, I mean, all of pro sports, really. But the Canadiens, their story is something else entirely.
Right.
OMG, for real? These two AI-generated hosts even pronounced Canadiens and Habs properly? I think I'm in love. But this is really not to brag, but kind of what I predicted, in that NotebookLM would somehow get integrated eventually into Google Gemini. What else should I predict? But really, this is audio overview from NotebookLM, but now available inside Gemini. So just like in NotebookLM, this is a podcast between two AI-generated hosts, a male and female, and you can share the podcast via this three-dot menu icon, or you can download it right from here. So you can use it whenever, wherever, and however you want. Ahem. Okay, easy content creation. For now, as of the recording of this video, audio overview is only available once you've uploaded files. I would love to see it eventually available through all our chats so we can make sense of all our normal chats in a more digestible manner. Wait a second. Did I just predict something again? Time will tell. Additional availability notes for you. Again, as of this recording, audio overview is only available in English, but more languages are coming soon. And both Canvas and audio overview are available completely free for Gemini and Gemini Advanced users, both on the web and your Gemini mobile app. So now I want to hear from you. Have you used Canvas or audio overview yet? What do you think of it? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or you can leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for more content just like this. Thanks for watching. See you next time.